happy. We're already 30 minutes in. Let's go on and dive into the, I guess, the major topic of the day. The XFL laid off nearly all of their employees, and they... I'm having trouble figuring this out. They laid off all the employees. There are no plans to come back for 2021. What happened? You know,
well, Corona happened.
Well, I understand Corona happened, and I get that, but...
You can't say you get that. That's what happened.
No, I know that it happened. What I'm saying is all of the talk beforehand was Vince McMahon put $500 million into this, and it was going to be good whether they had a TV deal or not for three seasons. They had everybody paid.
That's not true. That's not true. He already had a TV deal. That's why he was able to guarantee. And what I heard was two seasons. They were going to.
Yeah, it was two seasons of TV deal.
Two seasons, no matter what.
But the TV deal was not.
Had the TV deal.
The TV deal was not money, though. ESPN, ABC, Fox, FS1 were not paying a fee to broadcast these. All they were doing was paying for the production of it. Like that's so they weren't getting money from the television deal. This $500 million investment that Vince McMahon put in, it was supposed to make this thing last for three seasons. And now they get cut off in the middle of the first season, and we understand why. We understand coronavirus. We understand all of that. But to go on and lay everybody off when I think the season was supposed to end either this weekend or last weekend or whatever, and then to have no plan to come back next year. Like, I feel terrible for people like Oliver Luck that left a really good job doing what he loved in the NCAA, but wanted to jump at this opportunity and did his homework and talked to Vince McMahon and figured all this stuff out and said, okay, like, I believe he's not just going to jump out of it really quickly if it doesn't go right at first.
This isn't that, though. None of this is that, Gary. Yes, those TV deals were not for money, but they had ways to make money through television, and Vince knew that. Vince knew that they're going to sell ads, and we have an ad split. And the reason they weren't guaranteeing just a flat fee is because he thought he could generate more money than what those fees they would be willing to just pay for. And those products weren't really to pay anything, and everybody just agreed to some type of commercial ad split. All right, I'm going to give you the product, you produce it, and whatever revenue we generate, there's some fraction that we split that they agree upon, okay?
Okay.
He loses all of that here. So now everything he banked on having, because he thought, and I think he's right, because this guy knows television ads, he knows the people that are in this business because he's already selling them content for ads and things of that nature for his wrestling. He knows how to do these things, all right? I think he did the math and said, if we get one season from start to finish under our belt, we'll make enough money to go 3 years and be profitable. And therefore, this thing can't die. And what happened? He didn't even get half a season in.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, if you don't get half the first season and you were counting on that to carry you the next year and you had enough money banked where you could do a third year, it's over. And then he's also seeing the writing on the walls to where there's going to be so many sports kicked back, he doesn't know when his second season could even start.
That's a very valid point.
Middle of February.
Yeah. That's trying to start up again.
Now he's competing with all kinds of playoffs, all kinds of weird scheduling that he would normally not compete with.
Well, there was also such a window between the Super Bowl and the Masters that he was going to be able to fit it in there and have a full season. And now the Super Bowl being pushed back, even if the Masters comes back at the normal time, he would be going up against maybe Easter as well. Like all these different things that can seriously dampen.
I just think the writing was on the wall. Corona killed it. I think he had done the math. I think he had gotten the investors. I think he had raised the money. And I think it was all ready to go.
Yeah. And oh, I mean, there were no other investors. It was just him.
Well, I get that. But like he had
partners. There's no reason.
He had people that came into this thing that were a part of it. And I think it was all lined up. I think it was all planned. And I think Corona killed it. And I do. I absolutely do.
Yeah. It's a shame.
It was a fun product. The reason why.
No, you've got a valid point. It's why I was questioning everything because I said, man, you read all these articles back before this thing even started, and it was...
He had it all planned.
Yeah, this thing is good to go, and it will succeed, and
but he knew he could make television money off of the first year, and off of every year after that. He knew he could make TV money, but he had to have a product to sell them, and now, because he didn't get any upfront money from any of these people, and it was literally week by week selling ads as ratings come out, you know, basically selling stuff pay-per-click kind of thing.
Yeah.
And, you know, when you don't have your product to sell, everything goes, I mean, your whole formula goes away.
Yeah. Let's see. Michael Fritz jumped in on Twitch. He said, "Sup, fellas, finally got in." He's the one I accidentally blocked on YouTube the other day. Like, I got no idea what happened there.
You get that figured out?
I thought I had it figured out, but he's watching on Twitch now, so I'm glad he's there. I'm glad he's here. Let's go on and move off from that. Let's talk some NFL for a little bit. We'll close out.